Cobbiz.
Hello everyone, welcome to Cobbiz. My name is Pankaj Tyagi, and in this video, we will be talking about a government portal called GeM. Are you looking forward to grow your business as a sellers on an online marketplace but lack resources or idea for doing so? You can turn your dream into reality by registering on government portal called GeM. This video will guide you on how to become a registered seller on this portal. The term GeM stands for Government E-Marketplace. It is a web-based platform for public procurements in India. It was introduced by Ministry of Commerce and Industries and Government of India on August 9, 2016. GeM aims at improving efficacy and transparency in the public procurement of goods and services for government agencies and companies. The Finance Ministry has already clarified that all government buyers are mandated to procure resources from this portal itself. The provision for the same has been stated in a new rule number 149 in the Journal Financial Rule 2017. The GeM is a web-based portal that serves government agencies and department at large. It means that only government-based agencies are allowed to make purchase from this platform. But a good news is that any seller can be a part of this platform. That means no government status is required to become a seller on this portal. Presently, GeM offers two types of registration. First is buyer registration and second one is seller registration. Now let's talk about the seller registration on GeM portal. All those sellers who wish to sell their offerings or services to the government agencies have to first register themselves on this portal as a seller. There are two categories of sellers on this portal. One is authorized sellers and other is OEMs. The term OEMs refers to an original equipment manufacturer which makes systems or components for other entities serving the same area of interest. However, this is not a standard description of an OEM. In general, OEMs can be a manufacturer, brand owner, third-party manufacturer, importer, authorized seller, service providers, assembler. Now, we will shed some light on potential benefit offered by GeM to the registered sellers in India. Access to standardized market, security against delayed payment, ensure minimal marketing budgets, availability of flexible pricing based on marketing condition, multilingual support desk. As far as the documents are concerned for registration, GeM portal usually seeks the document like PAN, company information number, tax related documents and tenancy related papers from the sellers during registration. Now let us know some key facts regarding the process of seller registration on GeM. The registration process on GeM is completely online. Since GeM is a web-based portal for both seller and buyers, the registration and documents are also different for both of them. Presently, there are two types of accounts on GeM, that is primary sellers and secondary sellers. These accounts can be created on the seller account. Keep in mind that there will be always one primary seller or service provider for a company. This entity will by default have all privileges assigned to it. Next one is only primary sellers or service provider would have the leverage to create secondary seller or service provider. There can be multiple secondary sellers or service provider for a single entity. Secondary sellers undertaking are subjected to assigned role and privileges. There is no legal mandate for creating a secondary seller account as it entirely depends on company's requirement. Now let's dive into the process of registration for primary sellers on GeM portal. First, visit the GeM portal and create an account as a seller. You can do this by clicking sign up options located on the top left of the page. Next, click the drop down menu to select the option called seller. This will direct the portal to open the new page called create your organization seller account. Now on this page, click on the review terms and condition and go through the same and agrees to it if you find it relevant. After agreeing to terms and conditions, insert the detail relating to company and applicant in subsequent form. These details will be verified by portal. Once you are done with that, the portal will send the activation mail on your email ID that will help you log on to the seller desk. Next, complete the registration process by rendering and validating information such as PAN and Aadhaar number, company information, office location, GST, bank account, invoicing criteria, MSME registration, ITR, forbid participation, and DOE order compliance. Next, create a bank account that will be linked to GeM portal. During this process, you will be prompted to submit certain amount of deposit as a security. The charges for securities varies as per seller turnover. Finally, list your offerings, that is product and services, on the portal. There are options to either add a new category for your offering in the existing category if they exist, or insert a new category for your product services as well. For the rest, you are ready for selling your offering on GeM. This is all about the seller registration process on GeM portal. After addressing this requirement, a vendor assessment shall come into effect, under which seller candidatures will be verified as per the GeM guidelines. Only after the successful assessment, seller would be able to sell their offering on the portal. That is all about the GeM portal. Hope you like this video. Please share, subscribe, and like our video. Thank you.